We are going to discuss about one new disease condition, that is the hypothyroidism in the children. Okay, it is one of the childhood disorder. It will be there in the 6th unit, that is the children with various disorders and diseases. Okay, in child health nursing subject. Okay, in this hypothyroidism is one of the hormonal disorder. Okay, in that where it will be there, hormones, glands means. In which system in the body? Endocrine system. Okay, from the endocrine system, one disorder, that is the hypothyroidism. Okay, thyroid gland, you know. Okay, thyroid gland is a one gland. It will be secreting some thyroid hormones, no? Okay, what is the use? What is the function of thyroid hormone? Thyroid hormone having so many functions. Okay, in this first one is the in the presence of thyroid gland in the children, okay, the children are having the growth of long bones, okay, normal growth or excessive growth, okay, whatever it may be, the children will be having their growth and development means in the presence of this thyroid hormone, okay. Next, the thyroid hormone having some other functions like protein synthesis, okay. These are the major functions regarding thyroid hormone. Okay, next, this is introduction. Thyroid hypothyroidism definition. Okay, hypothyroidism is nothing but it will be low circulating level of thyroid hormones. Okay, thyroid hormone levels will be very low. Okay, there is no normal secretion of thyroid hormones. Okay, that condition we are called as a hypothyroidism. In the name is there, no? Hypo nothing but decreased or low level. Thyroidism, thyroid hormone decrease in the body, that condition we are called as the hypothyroidism. Okay, what are the causes? What is the reason why the children are having this hypothyroidism? Means congenital. First one is the congenital by birth. Means any abnormalities like structural abnormalities or functional abnormalities of the thyroid gland in the children by birth. Okay, sometimes in the pregnant mother having some thyroid problems like hypothyroidism, okay, it may be affects to the their fetal, okay, in the mother womb. Why? Because from the mother womb through the placental circulation, the blood circulation from the mother to fetus, no? Okay, that's why the children's also, the fetus also having the one problem like hypothyroidism. Okay, this is the one reason. Next, sometimes through the chromosomal abnormality or the genes or any genetical problems is there, means the fetus may be affected by this disease of hypothyroidism. Okay, next, another one is the thyroid agency. Thyroid agency is nothing but thyroid gland is there, means there is no structural abnormalities in the thyroid gland, but thyroid gland is there in the children, but some functional abnormalities is there. Okay, some of the functional abnormalities is there in the children, that's why the children are having the this problem of hypothyroidism. Next, another one is the iodine deficiency. When the children are taking food, no? Okay, in the food, some iodine deficiency is there in the food, means, okay, in the presence of normal, sufficient iodine is there, means there is no problem. Okay, insufficiency or deficit of iodine in the food means, okay, the children may be prone to get this disease of hypothyroidism. Okay, next, another reason like anti-thyroid medications. Okay, the mother in pregnant state, she will be used some anti-thyroid drugs. Why? Because excessive use of thyroid gland, thyroid medications, okay, that will be acts of suppressing thyroid hormone levels. Okay, actually the patient, they don't know how much dose we have to take. Okay, increased amount or large amount or overdose we are taking means some other complications will be there. ओके दे डोंट नो ड्यू टू द इग्नोरेंस और ड्यू टू द अनअवेयरनेस दे आर कंटिन्यूअसली यूजिंग ऑफ ओवर डोसेज ऑफ थायराइड मेडिकेशंस. ओके द थायराइड ग्लैंड नॉट सेक्रेटिंग सफिशियंट थायराइड हार्मोन देन द बॉडी और द चिल्ड्रंस मे बी गोइंग टू गेट हाइपोथायराइडिज्म. ओके नेक्स्ट वन इज द पैथोफिजियोलॉजी रिगार्डिंग hypothyroidism. Okay, what is the pathophysiology? Why the how the process means in this? First of all, inadequate secretion of thyroid hormones due to the structural abnormalities or the functional abnormalities or some other medications mother using or children's using means that may be leads to the inadequate or insufficient secretion of thyroid hormone. Okay, it leads to what happens means here the physical and mental process will be there. Okay, the children's physical process very slow. Okay, they are not doing any activities. Okay, next mental process, thinking capacity or memory. Okay, whatever it may be, that mental functions or the physical functions should be very slow. Who are having this? This is a thyroid hormone problem. Okay, it may be leads to what happens means depression of cellular enzyme system. Okay, in the body the cells, okay cells is there, no? Group of cells form a organ, group of organs form a systems, group of systems form a one human body, no? Okay, in that human body some cells having that function will be decreased or depressed. It leads to what happens means metabolic activities will be decreased. Okay, for example, we are doing some activity or we are eating food means the food should be digested through the metabolic process. Okay, like that some metabolisms, whatever it may be, the body metabolism, fat metabolism, protein metabolism, carbohydrate metabolism. Okay, what are the metabolisms is there in the body? The metabolism should be decreased due to the insufficient secretion of thyroid hormone. Okay, it leads to the decreased oxygen consumption. The cells cannot receive sufficient oxygen and sufficient nutrients. Okay, from the blood circulation they are not received sufficient oxygen or the sufficient nutrients. Okay, it may be leads to what happens means decreased body heat. Okay, within the body heat or temperature should be very decreased or very less. Okay, it leads to what happens means the children's may be prone to get hypothyroidism. Okay, this is the pathophysiology regarding hypothyroidism in the children. Clinical manifestations for the hypothyroidism disease in the children. Okay, how we will identify the children is exactly suffering with the one disease of hypothyroidism means depending upon the clinical features of the children. Okay, in this the first one is the first of all we have to assess the newborn babies. Okay, by birth from the 0 to 28 days of children's age group we are called as the what is that newborn baby. Okay, in that newborn baby when we will assess the newborn baby, the newborn baby having their large size. Okay, why? Because the low secretion or excessive secretion of this thyroid hormone, the children are having look like a large baby structure. Okay, next another one is the posterior frontanella should be opened. Okay, frontanella is there now in the newborn babies, anterior frontanella, posterior frontanella. Okay, in between skull bones of the posterior bones of the skull bones, occiput exactly. Okay, in that area the one frontanella is there. Okay, that frontanella should be by birth the frontanella is there. Okay, from the 1 month to 2 months of a period of newborn babies or children, okay, that frontanella will be closed. Okay, in this what happens means who are having this disease of hypothyroidism, those children are having the opening of posterior frontanelle. Okay, next another one is the children are having the jaundice. Okay, physiological jaundice, they are having a jaundice, nothing but it is one type of disorder in the liver. Okay, the liver having the some impaired their function or lose their function due to this the jaundice may arise in the children's. Next another one is the feeding difficulties. When the mother will give some feedings, breastfeeding to the children, the children or the infant or the newborn baby not receiving or not feed that breastfeedings. Okay, why? Because they are having impairment in the thyroid gland. Okay, next another one is the umbilical hernia or the oversleeping or poor muscle tone. When we will assess the newborn baby's body of the muscle, okay, the muscle tone will be very poor, very less. Okay, they are having the oversleeping continuously. Okay, 24 hours they are deep sleep. Okay, next another one is the when we will assess the children are having the tongue, large protrusion of trunk. Okay, tongue having the large size and protrusion. And another one is when we will assess the lips of the children, the lips should be very thick. And when we will assess the eyelids of the children, the eyelids having the puffiness. Okay, next another one is the when we will assess the nasal bridge of the children or the newborn baby, the nasal bridge having the depressed. Okay, straight nasal bridge not there in the children. Okay, next another one is the wrinkled forehead. When we will assess the children or newborn babies, okay, their forehead should be very wrinkles. Okay, some skin foldings we are assess. Okay, next another one is the this is the assessment of the clinical manifestations in the only newborn babies. Okay, in newborn babies they are not having their closure, they are not opened their posterior frontanilla. Sometimes the children or the newborn babies having large size and that physiological jaundice. Another one is the feeding difficulties. Okay, these are the newborn babies. Another one, children's. In children's, what are the changes they are assessed in the this disease of hypothyroidism means. In this first one is the children's are having the what is that slow growth. Okay, when we will assess of or when we will check or when we will measure the weight or growth of the children's, okay, height of the children, the height should be very less. Okay, growth failure will be there in the children's. Next another one is the head size, head circumference, height will be very large. Then the shoulder circumference. Next the children are very intolerant for cool environment. Okay, they are not tolerate for the coolness. Okay, when we will keep in a cool area, the children are having shivering. Okay, they are not tolerate for the coolness, cool weather. Next another one is the poor school performance. The children are coming to the school or enter into the classroom or the madam will give some assignments, some notes to the children, means they are not having good performance in that particular exams or assignment or classwork. Why? Because due to the hyposecretion of thyroid gland in the children. Okay, they are not they are changed in their mental talent or physical activity. Okay, that's why the children are having poor performance in the school level. Okay, next another one is the delayed skeletal maturation. The children are having the skeletal maturation will be late. Okay, these are the clinical manifestations. Next one is the assessment or diagnosis. As a nurse, how we will assess in the children's means, first of all, we have to collect the history of the mother. Why? Because the problem will be there in the neonatal, no? Okay, the neonate not give any answer, not having any answer, first of all. Okay, the neonates unable to speak. Why? Because they are not developing speech. Okay, that's why we have to collect complete history from the mother. Why? Because in antenatal period you have any hypothyroidism disorder or what medications you are using, if you have means. Okay, how many days you are suffering with this problem. Okay, the how much level is there that thyroid hormone. Okay, regarding that we have to collect history from the mother. Okay, why? Because the problem will be arising by birth only, no? Okay, after birth of the baby or by birth sometimes any congenital abnormalities is there, due to that the problem may be arise. Okay, Next one is the physical examination. Okay, in newborn baby we have to examine that muscle tone or forehead wrinkles or lip thickness or sometimes muscle tone weak or sometimes the children neonate will be deep sleep or oversleep or continuously they are having sleeping. Okay, what is their activity, the metabolic activities or the normal or any abnormalities is there. Regarding that, we have to collect a history from the children or parents. Okay, by assessment, by physical examination, we have to collect a history. We are identified and we have to verbalization or communicate with the parents. The mother will give accurate data regarding their disease condition. Okay, next another one is the neonatal screening. Okay, in this neonatal screening we have to assess the neonatal measurements like head circumference and chest circumference and height of the neonates, weight of the neonates. Okay, regarding that we have to screen the next. Another one is the thyroid gland. Okay, in this thyroid scan what happens means any structural abnormalities is there or any functional abnormalities is there in the thyroid gland. Regarding that we have to collect history by doing the some x-rays or some MRI scan. Okay, why? Because through the thyroid scan we have to assess the any increased level of thyroid stimulating hormone. Okay, sometimes that thyroxin levels, okay, T4 levels, okay, the levels may be increased or decreased, that will be assessed by doing the thyroid screen or scan. Okay, next another one is the bone x-ray. Why bone x-ray? Means the bones are not well developed in the children who are suffering with this disease of hypothyroidism. Okay, next another one is the treatment. As a nurse, what treatment we have to provide means we have to give symptomatic treatment. First of all, we have to check vital signs. And in this we have to give major therapy, that is the replacement of thyroid hormone. Why? Because the thyroid hormone levels will be very less. Okay, thyroid gland not supposed to the secretion of thyroid hormones. Okay, that's why we have to replace that thyroid hormone levels in the neonates for prevention of jaundice, for prevention of metabolic changes in the neonates, and for improving their growth of the children. Okay, for improving their health status, we have to replace the thyroid hormone. Okay, in that thyroid hormone therapy, for example, levothyroxine. Okay, levothyroxine medications we have to replace for the children or neonates who are suffering with the hypothyroidism disease. Okay, next another one is the everyday and day-to-day life or every month we have to check and measures the weight and height of the children. Why? Because the children are having delayed growth of their body. Okay, next another one is the we have to give some health education to the parents regarding replacement of thyroid hormone therapy. Okay, what is the importance of thyroid hormone? Okay, why the thyroid hormone is there in the body? Okay, what is the normal secretion, normal functions? Okay, regarding these we have to give complete and accurate information to the parents. Okay, why? Because they are maintaining follow-up care or follow-up checkups to the neonates for improving their health. Okay, by attending the clinics, by attending the continuously following that follow-up care, we have to control or we have to maintain normal thyroid hormone levels in the children's body. Okay, this is the management for the thyroid hypothyroidism disease children.